Bye, Ruby. Let's go outside. Come on. Ruby, honey, it's okay. It's okay. You get anxiety when we put on our shoes and get ready to go, right? But you're coming with us, honey girl. Right, baby? Right, baby? Hey. About to go to the vet. Hey guys, so I just want to get over here and like do a quick update real quick. Ruby's in the back just relaxing right now. You can see. She's pretty sleepy right now. So back when like when we got back from the vet, she took a little nap and then I fed her and I fed myself because honestly like we have to eat at the same time because she does not do well with us or me eating by myself and her just barking at me the whole time. So I try to eat at the same time as she does. So we normally eat at around 7 in the morning breakfast, noon or 1 lunch, and then 5, 6 dinner. So we had lunch right after the vet. And I just wanted to do a little quick update about how the vet went. The vet told us that she's doing pretty good. She looks healthy, she's been doing great. The only thing is that she still has like some issues with her going to use the bathroom. So what I've been doing is like I've been like making her chicken and stuff like that when I make myself chicken. So she eats literally the same thing, obviously with no seasonings or like no added condiments. So I usually give her chicken with her meals. The vet told us that to try to add potatoes or pumpkin, so I'm gonna do that as well. But she's been doing pretty well. I mean, she still has that issue, but she's still a baby, and we've changed her food about 3 times in a matter of like 5 months. So like having like issues with the bathroom is pretty normal for puppies. So I mean, she's doing pretty well right now. She got her rabies shot today, and she got one other shot that is important. She's had like 3, I think it's called a temper shot or something like that. And so she's doing pretty well. I'm very excited. She's growing really fast. She's getting used to like her specific times. Honestly, something I'm really grateful for not working is that I'm able to be with her. So even though I'm not working, I wake up like at 6 or 7 in the morning and take her out, feed her so she has a schedule. She usually likes to lay. I know I added a few clips already from the morning, but I didn't really say too much. But that's what I do every morning. I usually take her out as soon as I wake up, feed her, and then she takes a nap for a little bit. She likes to play for a little bit. And then So I used to lay in the sun a lot, which is gonna be kind of difficult, I feel, when it snows or it rains, because she hates the rain and she hates water. So we might have to do indoor potty training. So I don't know if you guys have any advice on that, but let me know in the comments. But right now, every time she has to pee or use the bathroom, we take her out. So, and she's been doing pretty well with that. She did have a few accidents, obviously, while potty training, but now she doesn't have many accidents at all, because I feel like me and her have found a way to communicate. So I know when she needs to go out, and she does things to let me know as well. She actually usually stands by the door in order to leave, so I know that she needs to go out. And she's very verbal, so she will tell me that she needs to go out. So yeah, right now it's about, I think it's about 2:30 p.m. Like I said, we already had lunch, and right now she's just relaxing, and that's normally what we do. I'm thinking of taking her on a walk in a little bit, because it's such a beautiful day out tonight, well, today. And then after that, we'll probably have dinner at around 5 or 6. And then it's just playing with her and making sure she's going out when she needs to go out, and making sure she's well being taken care of, because I love this girl so much, guys. You have no idea. Like, look at her. She's a sweet little angel, honestly. She's really sassy and stuff, like more than I thought she would be. But she's really, like, honestly worth it. Look at this girl. She's so worth it, honestly. So yeah, I mean, to be honest, if you're looking to adopt like a Basset Hound or get a Basset Hound, you need to understand, and that's what I didn't get from the beginning, and it was really stressful, is that they need a lot of care and attention, like more than normal dogs do, because they're really needy. So if you're planning to get a Basset Hound, just know that you're gonna have to spend a lot of time potty training them and being with them and finding a routine and figuring out a way to communicate. So she's been doing a lot better, and I'm really, really happy about it. So yeah, I'll see you in the next clip. Thanks for hearing me out on this long clip. So Ruby just woke up from her little nap, because she heard some noise. Look at her pretty eyes. That's my good girl. She just likes to sit here and stare sometimes into the outside. She loves to yawn like a million times too. Right, Ruby girl? Is that my good girl, honey? Oh my goodness. How did I get so lucky? How did I get so lucky with this pretty girl? Oh, there goes her yawning again. Yeah, that's my baby baby. Oh, my baby baby. Oh, my baby baby. She is just the sweetest little baby angel in the world. Honestly, and she's so gorgeous. Look at my pretty girl. And my pretty girl. Yeah, she's still a little tired. That's why her eyes are drooping. Oh, no. What do you want, honey girl? Oh, she's still tired. She's probably gonna relax for a little bit, and then we gotta take her out to do potty again. Or maybe she'll just go back to sleep. We'll see. Hey guys, so a little update. Ruby just woke up. She told me that she needs to go outside, so I'm gonna take her outside so she can go potty. And then we're gonna go on a walk, so stay tuned. Come on, Ruby. Come on, Ruby. Come on. Let's go. Hey, let's go. Come on. Good girl. Let's go. Come on. Come on, Ruby. Come on. Nope, come on. Nope. Guys, she just decided to venture off onto the rocks after she tried to attack my foot. She's having a good time right now walking, but I do not want her to go in the water. And the worst thing about living here is like, there's geese poo everywhere. Like if you can't see Lincoln, like, she'll try to eat it. So I'm trying to walk. Come on, man. Come on. And there she goes. She's trying to bite my leg again. It's a little chilly, but it's not too bad. It's a beautiful day. No, come on. Guys, to be honest, like, just came back from the walk, but Ruby loves eating geese poo, and it's such a pain in the ass to, like, stop her from doing it. So I had to pick her up and carry her home the last 2 minutes, and it's kind of kept getting cold, and she was being really, like, mouthy and stuff, so had to cut this trip a little short. She's not very happy about it, but, I mean, that's the only horrible part about here is like there's geese everywhere because we have like a little pond in the middle, and she just loves eating geese poo. So but now she's just drinking her water. That was a lot of exercise for her. So in about like an hour and a half, we're gonna have dinner. Right now she's probably gonna be, honestly, this is like the most annoying time when she just like wants to like play a ton because she has so much energy still even after our walk. So she gets really like mouthy because she's teething, so I have to give her toys and like play fetch with her, which she's been doing pretty well with. But yeah, we're probably just gonna relax right now. But there she is, little Miss Sassy Ruby. By the way, there's a shoe in there because she loves chewing that shoe, so the person who owns it just volunteered for her to have it because she loves chewing it. This is her little crate. She has a blankie, a shoe, her water bowl, her food bowl, and a few toys she sleeps in there with. So we'll see what she wants to do for now, but I will see you guys in the next clip. Hey guys, so since the last clip, Ruby woke up. I just took her out to potty. She did some pee-pees. And right now it's about 5:30, almost 6 o'clock, and we had lunch at around 1, so it's definitely time for dinner. And she is ready, let me tell you. She knows it's time for dinner. So what I usually do, I'll put you guys maybe over here. Hold on. Where we can see. Oof. Can you guys see me? Or maybe not. I'll put you guys over here. But I want to show you guys what I do for her food, because right now I'm cooking mine and we have to eat at the same time, like I said. Alright, so it is what it is, sorry. So normally she starts barking during this time, but I grab her bowl. I grab about, this is a cup and a half of her normal dog food. So I put that first in her bowl. And I give it to her in 3 portions, depending on how hungry she is and how much time I need like to eat. Because if she finishes before me, she does this. Like she'll start barking at me. I have her chicken in a container. And she loves her chicken so much, so she literally will not stop bothering me until I give her her food. So, I grab, like, depending on how much food I'm giving her, I grab her some chicken and shred it up into her food. And I, again, make it last for 3 portions. And she always gets it. She's a hungry girl. So I just finished prepping everything up and I'm basically eating this. It's chicken and potatoes with a little bit of jardinera sauce and ketchup because I had a lot of vegetables for breakfast and for lunch, so I'm feeling like carbs right now. And I got Ruby's food. She knows it's time. Come on. She's barking at me. Like always. So I'm gonna give it to her right now. So I'll show you.
All right, Ruby, come here.
Come on. So I close her cage because she likes to come out with her food. And she's gonna enjoy her food. And so am I.
Guys, I just want you guys to see her teeth. We just finished eating, by the way, and I put her on the couch because she wanted to come up here, and she's definitely teething. She's a freaking monster, bro. Like, she's a freaking monster. You can see her. Ow! Ruby. She doesn't still understand, like, she's not supposed to bite people. Ruby, look! Your toy! So I've been trying to just give her toys whenever she needs to, like, teeth. Or whenever she gets, like, mouthy like this. She's mad. Oof. Look at this girl. I'm telling you, she's sassy. Oof. My little Basset. Yep, look at that mouth. She's so weird. But yeah, we're probably just gonna relax. And we can't do much more. There's no more eating. So we just gotta relax and chill the rest of the night. Look at that tummy. She's satisfied. She's probably gonna have to use the bathroom soon as well. So, yeah.
Hey guys, I just wanted to come over here and end the video. Ruby's getting a little antsy and she wants to play, so I don't really want to keep her from her. As you can hear from the audio, she needs a lot of attention right now, so I kind of just want to finish off the video. I want to say thank you for tuning in to my video. Make sure you subscribe, you like, and I hope that's giving you an insight to how it is to have a Basset Hound or even a new puppy. Because it is a lot of caring attention. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope to see you in the next video. We're just gonna say bye.
Bye.